Again, welcome to my channel Engineering Made Simple. Now we were studying K-map method for simplification of our system equation. Now in the previous part we studied how to simplify a given expression using K-map when it is given in standard SOP form. Now in this part we will study how to simplify a given system equation using K-map technique only, but which is given in a standard POS form, that is product of sum form, that is when mean terms, max terms are given for the expression. So now let us study that. So now let us learn how to simplify a given expression which is given in standard POS form using K-map method or graphical method. Now for that let us start directly with an example. So this is our example. Example states that implement the following boolean function or system equation using basic gets and simplify the function using the K-map. So this is the boolean function given over here, that is f is equal to pi of capital N in bracket 0, 2, 5, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14. Now remember this, when capital M is used and pi is used, you should know that the system equation or boolean function is given in the form of max terms. So basically these all terms, that is 0, 2, 5, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14 are max terms of the given function, boolean function or system equation. Now we were supposed to simplify it using K-map, and then we are going to realize it using basic gates, that is AND or NOT gates after simplification. Now 0, 2, 5, 7, 8, 10, 12, 14. Now let us start filling the K-map. This is a 4 variable K-map which I have drawn because the maximum value of max terms till it goes is 14. So the K-map should contain minimum 14 boxes or cells. So that is only possible when K-map is a 4 variable one, because it has 16 boxes. So that's why here, now let us start filling max terms over here. Now what is the max term? Max term are the terms, are the input combinations that produce logic 0 at the output. So we will fill all these things with zeros. Now here 0 0, here 0, max term is 0, so we will fill it with a 0. And then 2, we will fill it with a 0. 5, 7, 8, okay, then 10, 12 and 14. Okay, so we have filled it. Now whatever max terms are not given, that are not included in this max term list, are mean terms. So let us fill the rest of the columns with 1. So because in any logic circuit there will be only 2 outputs, and we are filling outputs of a digital circuit in a K-map, remember this. So these were the max terms given, so we filled the corresponding cells with zeros. And now whatever is not a max term, it is a mean term. So let us fill rest of the columns with 1. Now we have filled rest of the columns with 1. But one interesting thing to note here is that we want the expression in our standard POS form. So we will group together max terms over here. So how we will group those? Have a close look over here. I am using different color pen so that it will be easier for you to understand. So this 4 corner elements, these four max terms. So as you can see, I have encircled it in such a manner that these form a quad of max terms. So this is a quad of max term. And then again, here also one pair of max term is formed, that is max term number 5 and 7. Form a quad. Remember, when you are solving for POS form, don't ever group once, because we are used to group once when we are deriving or simplifying expression in SOP form. But whenever POS form is asked, you are not supposed to group it with 1. Only the terms except max terms you are supposed to fill it with 1, but you will not use in grouping or simplification process. So that this thing should be pretty much clear to you. Then again, we will form a quad over here. This one, that is 14, max term 10 and max term 14, and max term 12 and max term 8 will form a quad over here. So we have finished the maximum available groupings over here. Now let us start analyzing this. Now have a look at the labeling of the K-map also. So this sequence is gray code, which is similar. This side represents, that is the horizontal side, vertical side represents AB, and horizontally the column represents variable CD. But now we are dealing with max term. So here also one thing changes. Now observe, this gray code sequence is the same, that is 00, 01, 11, 10. Here also gray code sequence is same, that is 00, 01, 11, 10. But remember, as we are dealing with max terms over here, so whenever I say 00, it would be A plus B. Similarly, when we are dealing with CD variables, it would be C plus D. Because max terms means it is a 0, right? Because they are those input combinations for which output of the circuit is 0. So wherever you see 0, you will not write the variable in complemented form. You will write it in uncomplemented form, which is exactly opposite of your SOP K-map. So here A plus B will be there because here 00 is present. Wherever 01 is present, you will write A, and wherever 1 is present, you will write that variable in complemented forms. That is, here 1 is present, so it corresponds to B complement. So A plus B complement. And this also, you see these terms are in product of some form. So see, A bar plus B bar, because both 1s are there, and max term corresponds to 0. That's why I have written A bar plus B bar, because 1 is there, yeah, at the input, and A bar plus B. Similarly, for our horizontal column also over here, CD, 00 stands for C plus D, 01 stands for C plus D bar, 11 stands for C bar plus D bar, because we are dealing with max terms, and 10 stands for C bar plus D. Now we have grouped this, we have formed groups, we have formed a quad over here, this is a quad over here, this is another quad, adjacent 40, this is another quad, and this is a pair. Now let us start simplifying it. So for simply, when we move on to simplification, so now let us see how will you simplify. First have a look at this quad, that the four zeros at the corner of the quad. This is a quad, right? So now here we have term A plus B, here we have a term A bar plus B. So what is changing? A is changing to A bar. So A is eliminated. So here, so for this particular quad, this one, we will have term B, because A will be eliminated from this particular row. You see A bar plus B and A plus B. Now have a look at the CD part of the column. Now here we form a quad, right? So this is nothing but C plus D, because this is common to this one also and this one also. So we are forming a quad. So C plus D and C bar plus D. So here C changes to C bar. So that is varying. So that gets eliminated and only D remains. So this particular corner, this four corner zeros, that is max term, will give a term called as B plus D. Now we will move on to a pair which is present over here. Now, what does this row correspond to? A plus B bar. So that A plus B bar will remain as it is, because we are reading the rows exactly. Now, what is varying? The column over here, that is C plus D bar and C bar plus D bar. As you can see, here C changes to C bar. We are talking about this particular term. That is, C changes to C bar, but D bar is constant at both the places. So here again we will have D bar. So this pair gives this term, that is A plus B bar plus D bar. And then here one more quad is formed between max terms 12, 8 and 14 and 10. So this particular one, bigger one. Now how will you analyze this? Now here A bar plus B bar is there and A bar plus B is there. As you can see, A bar remains constant. So for this particular quad, we will write A bar from here. And then observe the corresponding column. So C plus D is there, and in the last column C bar plus D. Also here C changes to C bar, so that is varying. So only D will remain, that is A bar plus D. Now so your final answer would be Y is equal to बी प्लस डी इंटू ए प्लस बी बार प्लस डी बार इंटू ए बार प्लस डी, दिस इज योर फाइनल आंसर. So now we have simplified this particular boolean function using k map. So this is the output after this is the answer after simplification, that is y is equal to a bar plus d a plus b bar plus d bar into b plus d. Now this expression is in simplified expression or minimized expression is in POS form, but they have asked us to do one more thing, that is implement a given circuit using basic gates. Whenever somebody asks you to implement a circuit, so now they have asked you to implement the circuit using basic gates. So whenever somebody asks you to implement a circuit using basic gates, that is we have to use AND OR NOT gates only while drawing the circuit diagram. So now, so this is our final expression. We want to draw it circuit diagram using basic gates. Now basic gates are AND OR and NOT. So here I have three inputs A, B, D I have written. And I have obtained its complements also, because we require the complements of the following variables a bar, b bar, d bar, by passing it to a NOT gate. But now let's start implementing the circuit. First term in our expression is a bar plus d. So this is a bar plus d. So I have connected a bar and d as inputs to one OR gate, whose output I will get a bar plus d. So this is how I will get the first term. Now similarly for the second term. Second term is nothing but a plus b bar plus d bar. So a plus b bar plus d bar. So these three are applied as inputs to an OR gate. So I will get an output a plus b bar plus d bar. So I get the second term. And then the final third term, that is b plus d. So here the signal line for b is this. So b and d are applied as inputs to an OR gate, so that I get b plus d. So now all these three terms we have got. Now we are supposed to multiply those. How will you multiply do multiplication in any digital system? By using AND gate, because we are told to use only basic gates. So these three inputs, so the outputs of the three OR gates are applied to the AND gate to get the final expression y is equal to a bar plus d into a plus b bar plus d bar into b plus g. So this is how you solve this particular type of examples.
Yes.
So if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell icon for notification of all my latest uploads.